Throughout most of history, ice was only available for people who had too much of it, those who lived in the freezing cold. But for the rich in the 1800s, there was a business in ice, the ice trade. In the wintertime, workers sawed up blocks of ice from frozen lakes and rivers. They stored it in barns and covered it with sawdust to slow the melting. And then, in the summer, icemen on horse-drawn wagons sold it to butcher shops and breweries and rich customers. It was a major industry. But the ice came in large blocks and was financially out of reach for most people without a large commercial icebox. And the ice wasn't suited for the transportation of fish, meat, fruits and vegetables. Or medicine, vaccines and blood for transfusions for that matter. We needed something way more cool. Refrigeration came along in the late 19th century and was built on the insight that when a fluid evaporates from a surface, it takes heat along with it. Lots of innovators searched for the best liquids whose molecules evaporated fastest. Many different refrigerators were developed and improved upon. Even Einstein got a patent for one. And there was still the problem of transportation. The French engineer Charles Tellier designed a system for cooling cargo holds in ships and tested it in 1876 when he sent a cargo of fresh beef from France to Argentina. On arrival, the steaks were 105 days old, but reportedly excellent, bloody, and savory. Hurrah! 1,000 times for the revolutions of science and capital, declared an Argentinian newspaper. Now the surplus of one continent could fill the stomachs of another. But the new cooling system didn't cut ice with truckers. When exposed to the jolts of the road, it often broke down. It took a self-taught African-American mechanic based in Minnesota to change that. In the 1930s, Frederick McKinley Jones invented a practical refrigeration unit for trucks that actually worked. It was designed for perishables, but the US Army also saw the potential. Jones's cooling units were lifesavers, preserving medicine and blood for troops in battle across the ocean. The cold chain that combined three major innovations, ship, truck, and home refrigeration, made the modern food industry possible and greatly reduced waste. These are the products of human ingenuity that gave us year-round access to meat, fish, and fresh produce, and significantly reduced the cost of feeding our families. In 1930, we spent almost a quarter of our disposable income on food. Today, it's less than a tenth. And at last, that luxurious dessert, once exclusive to Roman emperors who could send runners into the mountains for snow, became a cheap treat for kids.
Hey, check out these other great videos from Free to Choose Network. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get updated on episodes of New and Improved with me, Johan Norberg.